fall in love, it will be forever, 'cause I'll never ever fall in love again. Hi, this is Ken Boothe, and I want you to just tune in to Island Rhythms. Don't move that remote, and if it's radio you listen to, don't move the dial neither. Ken Boothe says so.
Yes, we are ready. I've been ready. I've been waiting for you all day, ladies and gentlemen. The legendary Ken Boothe.
What a, so much patience is all right.
Yes, all the time, just for you.
No.
You have
I like
been.
A compliment, but I know it's just at yourself.
No, it is true. You are a legend.
Thank you very much.
You are part of the material. Yes, a very long. 53 years in the business. And you started when you were 8 years old.
Yes.
Won your first contest at 8 years old.
Yes.
Do you remember that day?
Yeah, I remember it. Because in those days, my mother had to walk with me, you know. Because we didn't have a bicycle, not even bicycle. I grew up into not so much of a fortunate parents, family, you know. And so gradually we get fortunate, but those days my mother have to walk with me to the YMCA on North Street in Kingston. Yes, and so much, but when I won these contests, you know, some of the songs I make up my own words, you know, although it's a foreign song. But you know what, I thank the Lord God for my mother, you know. My mother have 7 of us, you know, and the first is an entertainer. She died now, Hyacinth Clover, and I'm the last, you know, and both of us took up entertainment, but we all got it from my mother, you know. She's a Negro spiritual singer, you know.
And that is why you love Mahalia Jackson.
I want to live the life I sing about in my song. I love her, you see.
My mother, she's like family.
I'm gonna live the life I sing about in my song. I'm gonna stay right and I'll always shun the wrong. Oh, I love that song.
Yes.
But you know, people should live what they do, you know.
Yes.
Like I sing, I try to live what I sing. And it's one of the things that why I love this song so much, because it's a very serious song. You must live what you express each
and
day.
You must love it.
And you must love it also. Thank you very much. Do it better than one.
Yes. Yeah. And let me tell you something. Growing up in a household of not just Caribbean parents, but as West Indians, Ken Boothe was part of that Sunday music that they played right after they played Mahalia Jackson and all the Negro spirituals. Right after that, Daddy would spin a Ken Boothe record. So we grew up listening to you. So you became a part of the household.
Right.
And now I'm hoping that people are teaching that to their children coming up.
Even tonight, the performance that I've done, I know a lot of kids out there are young. And for them to get to know us, there is a mommy and daddy playing our songs. And so they got familiar with the song. And so sometimes when I'm in Jamaica and some young people see me, they don't know me. When somebody say, "Is him singing everything I want to hear them?" And they are young people, but the parents, I guess, you know, growing up in a home that with love is good for us, you know, all of us. I grew up in a house with love, you know. My father and mother weren't that fortunate, but they bred us and fed us with a little bit that they had. And so I can never forget that, never, you know. I love music.
Yes, and you can see that in the music that you create, your work, the things that you do, and sharing not just with us here, but with the world.
Look, I just came off tour, you know. I was in Europe. Every year I've done it, you know. Yes, I was in Austria. First time I've been to Austria. Switzerland. I was in Rome, France, Belgium, you know. And I've been in these places before. But some of them is new, you know. Like every year I go to new places. And I love it. I really love to entertain. Because what entertainment has done for us, you interact with people from different cultures, you see. You know, and that's why I said on stage, you know, everywhere I perform, I say this: music is not black and it's not white. It's not white and it's not black.
It's universal.
It's universal. It's for all of us. Oh, yes. Music is good food, you know.
Music is love.
It's lovely taste.
Music is people.
Yeah.
Music is
and coming
everything.
From a young person like you, I appreciate it.
Well, you know, yes. I appreciate all the hard work that you've put into our culture.
I always say this, you know, that the singers and players of instruments and the radio personality, TV personality, the journalists, we all are compatible.
We are.
And remember, I tell you that, right?
We are. are. We are do the same thing. We all live the same life and walk
show business.
Almost the same
There's
path.
There's no
show
business like show business. Business. There's no business I know. Oh my God. What a business, huh? So much joy and so much pain.
And all, and all the same thing. It can make you happy. It can make you sad. And that's why you put it out on the paper.
I love the happy part of it.
What are one of the songs that you wrote that inspired you? And can you remember why you wrote that song? What, were you feeling loved at the time? Were you in love?
The first song that comes to mind is "The Train Is Coming." Want to know why? Because I grew up in Denham Town, right? And the only automobile we could really touch is the train. You know, we didn't go in a plane or anything like that. But when we're going to the beach, you have to pass a railway station. So I could touch the cars, you know. So I lay down one day and I wrote "The Train Is Coming." But I turned it into a love song. Because, you know, the train is coming, baby. So long I've been waiting on you. You know, the time. So we're going to take this train.
Yes.
Oh, yes.
Yes, and let's go with a little bit of that. We're going to take you out with "The Train Is Coming."
Train is coming, baby. Said the train is coming now. Said the train is coming, baby. Said the train is coming now. So long I've been waiting. Hey, waiting on you. Yeah, man, the train.
Yes.
And it's still a coming and a stop yet.
Yes, and it's always going to be coming. Ladies and gentlemen, an honor, the Honorable
Diva.
Ken Boothe.
And your name is?
Yes. Yes.
Repeat your name.
Diva J.
Diva J. Thank you so much.
It's been a blessing, an honor.
Thank you so much. You have the right personality.
Thank you.
You're right personality.